prior to any work being done, drain the oil from the gearbox from the drain plug down below and neutralize or flush out any chemicals that's in the pump head. My name's Tim Fagan from Neptune Chemical Pump. I'm the service manager, and we're gonna go through removal of the diaphragm on a 500 series pump. First thing you wanna do is you wanna remove the bolts. Easiest to do that because of the parts that are inside the pump, we wanna lay down the pump. Remove the bolts. We have two bolts left to take out. The pump is on its side because there are going to be some loose parts that are going to be inside the pump head. So it'd be a lot easier to do it on the side rather than upright where the parts can fall out. As you can see, the pump head comes off. Here you'll see we have the backup plate. You'll see that it's concaved. It has an imprint for the fluid to come through. We recommend to check in between the holes to make sure there's no cracks developing. If there is, obviously we want to replace it. That you can set that in the concave part towards the liquid end. Diaphragm is next. Diaphragm is made of Teflon. You'll see that it has an imprint on the outer surface. That's where from the head on both sides to make a seal from the oil and the liquid of the pump. We always recommend never to put a used diaphragm back into the pump because it's, again, Teflon, which has no memory, so it can't snap back and seal as properly as a new one will. Next, you'll see the oil side backup plate. Just grab a pen or something small to get in the hole to get it out. Again, check for cracks in between the holes, replace if necessary. The thing is, with the oil side backup plate versus the liquid side backup plate, it's the same pattern. The difference is this is made of steel on the oil side, and the liquid side is the material that's being used, and again, in this case, it's stainless steel. You'd never want to switch them, especially with corrosive chemicals. You can damage the oil side backup plate if it's in the wrong position. So always keep it in the proper position oil side. Okay, so oil side backup plate goes back in, concave down, diaphragm fits on the outer surface perfectly. Liquid side head, I like to grab it with two fingers, slip it on, and you can rotate it right onto the head. Two long bolts on top. Smaller bolts down below. Tighten down the bolts. When tightening them down, you want to tighten them down in a star pattern, like you're changing your tire. Top, bottom, up, down. And the bolts get torqued down to 25 foot-pounds. And that's how you change a diaphragm in a 500 series pump. Footnote, that diaphragm change also goes into our other pumps, our other hydraulic pumps. The 600 series, the 6000 series, and the 560 series is all basically the same type of diaphragm, except for things are just a little bit bigger on higher flows, but it's the same premise when changing the diaphragm. The only thing I would note is on higher pressure pumps, the torque rating on the bolts could be higher. Please check your manual for that information.
PSG, where innovation flows.